We'll talk about kind of what you've been doing recently a little bit later, but I want to start and I want to look back at this your time at UVM that you spent 4 years. You know, you're going to go down in history and all the record books, but growing up in Chicago, who were your idols growing up?
You know, it's hard to say. Like, I really looked up to a lot of goalies in particular. You know, the Blackhawks were really good growing up, winning cups, but my favorite goalie growing up was Jonathan Quick, who was actually, like, you know, the Hawks rival at the time. So you know, all my buddies from school were big Hawks fans. I was kind of a Kings fan because you know, I really liked the way Jonathan Quick played. I really liked the way you know, so I kind of jumped on, like, the Kings bandwagon at that time. But I more of just kind of picked goalies and kind of just followed teams from there.
Did you ever play anything else besides goalie, or were you always a goalie?
No, I was pretty much always a goalie. Once I started in Mites, my dad was one of the coaches, and I actually remember him saying, because the kids would rotate by game to play goalie, I remember him saying, like, do not play goalie. And then they asked for a volunteer, and I immediately put my hand up. So then I was a goalie, and I just remember making, like, a glove save in the game. I probably gave up like 10 goals, but it was just, like, the coolest thing ever. And from then on, I just stuck with it.
Why didn't he want you to play goalie?
I just think he didn't want to deal with having a goalie as a kid, which I don't blame him, but he ended up being, like, my goalie coach growing up and everything, and he still helps me out a ton. So he adapted as well. But it was just, I still remember that, though, seeing his face as I just kind of put my hand up. He was like, oh, gosh.
Just because goalies are, like, a different breed, is that why?
Yeah, it's more to handle. You got to go through all the gear growing up and everything like that. So, you know, my older brother at the time, too, was a forward, and we were playing together at the time. It was just, you know, more for him to deal with.
Sure. I was a goalie at a much, much lower level. And I was a lacrosse goalie, but that was my parents' reaction too, just because, like, I was going to be taking, in lacrosse, you don't really wear pads. So, like, I was like,
yeah, I think that's crazy.
Yeah. And you have to be a little psychotic to do it.
Right.
I mean, there's a level of, why would you choose this? That goes into it for sure.
So, yeah, I think that lacrosse goalies, the amount of bruises they must get are more than what we take.
Oh, sure, for sure. So you walk in your freshman year to UVM. What was that first practice like? What were your feelings? What went into that?
You know, I would definitely say that I was ready to come into college. I was coming off of two successful years in the USHL. And, you know, our entire freshman class then was pretty talented. And we had such a good team that we were just, like, hungry and wanted to contribute to our team's success. So it was definitely a step up, definitely nervous, but we were so excited just to be on campus, you know, to be involved with what our team was doing, that every day was just exciting, really.
Yeah, in preparation for this, I watched an interview that you did with Alistair in your freshman year. Do you remember that?
I believe so. Was it in the stands, I believe?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember that.
What was it like your freshman year to immediately start playing, and what did you learn that first year?
I think more than anything, big picture-wise, I learned how to manage a full workload of a season. You know, we were just winning a ton of games, and we were, you know, having a lot of success, but, you know, I think that there was times where I kind of got worn down a bit and tired throughout the year. And it was something where, you know, looking at a 4-year picture, I was able to learn and, be able to manage, like, my body and mentally for a full grind of a season. But, you know, in all that freshman year, we were playing so many big games, you know, beating ranked teams, winning the Friendship Four out in Belfast. And that year especially just flew by. Like, Christmas break, I felt like, happened within a month. And then we were in the hockey's playoffs in another month, and then it was over. And then, you know, you're saying bye to your seniors, and they're like, it flies by. And then, you know, fast forward 3 years, which felt like 1 year, you know, you're a senior then. So
I think it was in your junior year, you go to Michigan, you have 48 saves, and you guys beat Michigan. And I've interviewed multiple players now, and that seems to be the game that they bring up the most. So what was that experience like for you, and what do you remember about that game?
Yeah, I mean, that was obviously a pretty big one. Like, starting the year off there, upsetting them in their building during their homecoming, everything was, it was pretty cool, and definitely like a memorable win. I remember going in there kind of feeling like we owed them one, because we went there and lost two the year before, and that kind of stuck with me, and I know it stuck with a lot of other guys too. And just the way that game went, I feel like every shot we took, you know, was going in, and you know, we got a pretty big lead, and then the third period especially, we were just kind of holding on, and they threw a lot at us, and the shots obviously climbed, but that was a pretty awesome way to start the year.
Do you have a favorite story or moment from the road?
Yeah, I would say that the Belfast trip our freshman year was a pretty cool road story, just going out to Ireland for the entire week, winning that tournament, and just kind of, you know, just being out there pretty much in a hotel with the guys, hotel to the rink, to, you know, sightseeing in Belfast, and then, you know, being able to win that tournament, and then, you know, share that time with the team afterwards. There was a lot of pretty good memories that came out of that that weekend. But, you know, when we would go to you know, some unfamiliar places like Arizona State or even Nebraska, Omaha, or Michigan, those were always fun weekends where we would fly out the next day, stay the night. But a lot of the times where we would have to go to common places and bus back after, road trips aren't the most exciting.
That's true. But I do think from my time with minor league baseball and UVM women's basketball, it's where you kind of bond the most with people. It's where you start to actually get to know them on a deeper level. And I'm sure you felt that with your teammates.
On the road, obviously, is where, you know, the foundation of most of like our friendships were developed, and the travel and the hockey schedule was pretty short. Like the majority of trips were like three, four hours, but, you know, spending the time in the hotel with, you know, with a group of guys on like a, you know, Thursday night before the game, or then, you know, decompressing after games throughout that weekend is kind of when you're able to especially connect with some of the newer guys that might be in the dorms, or some guys you don't see all the time, you know, when you're at home.
So your top five in all of the major goaltending statistics with UVM, but what are you the most proud of from your time at UVM?
I'd say the one that I'd be most proud of would be the save percentage statistic. I think the majority of the stats, I'm right behind Tim Thomason. And I would kind of joke about it coming in, saying like, you know, he's also a shorter goalie. I'm going to go there and beat his records. And it was kind of like a, you know, a thing I would say with my buddies or with my parents, but, you know, in the back of my head, like I wanted to be, you know, the best goalie I can be. And I wanted to be one of the best goalies at this school. And the save percentage is one that I was able to do that for. The other ones I got close, but, I think if I had a fifth year, I can catch them.
So now you're in the ECHL and you're playing in Fort Wayne for the Komets there. What lessons did you learn from UVM that you can take on as you work in pro hockey?
I think the biggest thing is just being a consistent goalie. Like a lot of times, you know, throughout my career, there was a lot of playing time and a lot of, you know, situations where where I'd have to, you know, either put a night away, good or bad, and just focus on the next night and that task at hand. And, you know, here already we've played 6 games in the first 10 days. So, you know, by the time that game's done, no one really cares what happened there. It's more of, you know, what's going to happen tomorrow. And, you know, I think throughout the 4 years at college, learning how to manage a full college season is going to come in hand as we start getting more games played, getting down the road here too. But, you know, I think a lot of it really does correlate, and, you know, I'm looking forward to for the season to continue here.
So I know we've been affected by COVID-19 a lot here at UVM, and it's just kind of affected the pace of play and the ability to, you know, keep playing. How has that affected you once you graduated? How did that affect everything, you know, in terms of you trying to play hockey at the next level?
Yeah, so I played my last college game at UMass. I believe it was March 8th or 9th. Signed with Fort Wayne. I played one game, and then the next day, the league got suspended. So I was sitting on one pro game until last week, because the ECHL started in December, but Fort Wayne wasn't able to start then, so we started in February. So it was pretty much a 10-month gap of waiting to play and you know, staying ready. So it's just been, obviously, I'm thankful to be able to play. Not a lot of people are in that same situation, but you know, it's been a long time coming, I feel like.
What are your goals for the future?
You know, I think short term is just to, you know, just to put up wins and good numbers in this league and hopefully move up the rankings. I don't really want to put a cap on what I can do, but I think it's more of, here at Fort Wayne now, team-oriented goals and getting to the playoffs and trying to win a championship this year.
Have you been able to catch up on any UVM hockey this season?
Yeah, for sure. The last couple weeks, I guess before the last pause, I got to Fort Wayne and things kind of sped up for me. But earlier in the season, I was able to tune in to most of the games and follow along. So it's been cool to see the you know, the development of the new guys and see what Coach Woodcroft is building here.
What's your message for UVM players, as someone who's graduated? What would you say to them?
Just enjoy it. It's honestly, it's the best 4 years, even during, you know, COVID and this time. Like, there's not a city better than Burlington, and spending it with your teammates. Like, even when everything got shut down, like my apartment, we all went back to Burlington and we spent like another 3-4 months there. And like, that is even some of my best memories, being out in Burlington. And that's just what that city and that school provides. And you blink and you're gone. And now you're, you know, if you're in pro hockey, it's much more of a business now. And it's not, you know, it's not the same environment as Burlington provides all the time.
No, it's really sad that nothing's really happening here in Burlington, because, you know, that's one of the best parts about living here, is like the college town atmosphere, for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a place that I definitely want to continue to go back to for the rest of my life. And I feel like it's a place that I'll have a second home at, you know, forever.
Well, we wish you the best. And, you know, everyone here in Catamount Country is certainly rooting for you. So good luck with everything going on for you. It sounds like busy schedule.
Yeah, absolutely. Things are finally busy again. And no, thank you. I appreciate it. And good luck to the Cats as well.